Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ines Alea from TolerateTheCinematics.com, and today it's another Motion Graphics Monday. Alright, so in this tutorial we're going to see how to create a nice and simple title reveal entirely made in Adobe Premiere Pro. It's really simple to create, although After Effects is more specialized in making these kind of titles. I know that a lot of people don't have Adobe After Effects or are afraid of Adobe After Effects because it's so complex. So that's why I decided to make this tutorial on showing you how to create this title. But again, if you are planning to make more titles in the future, I would definitely encourage you to check out Adobe After Effects because it's just so much easier to create a nice title. Also, if you want, you can use our Essential Graphics, which is the exact same kind of style as the intro that we're going to be creating today, but it's a little bit more advanced and it has been created in Adobe After Effects and exported as an Essential Graphics, which you can use in Adobe Premiere Pro, where you easily change the text and the color. And if you buy it, it also helps to support the channel, so that would be awesome. Apart from that, let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and see how it is done. Alright, so here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro. So what we will do is create something like this, and then it also goes back away. So the fun thing is actually that we can actually click on this and extend this layer, and now if you're going to play it, it's gonna stick within our animation until it actually goes away at the end of the clip. The end animation sticks to the end animation, and then right here for the beginning animation, the same thing. It only starts wherever you trim your video to, so that's pretty cool. I already made a tutorial on that. I will add a card on that if you want to check that out. But yeah, let's start here from scratch. So I'll create a new sequence, full HD, and rename this to simple title reveal intro, for example, and click OK. And then right here, we are going to make this a little bit bigger and fit it to the work area and kind of set up my workspace here to make a nice title. The first thing that you need is, of course, a text. So go to your text tool and click here and just write something, which is what you should do. If you want to see more of my awesome videos, definitely hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. Okay, so back to the tutorial. We're going to rename, well, actually pick another font. So I'm going to select my text, go to the text and search for the Lato font, which is my favorite font. And you probably already know that if you follow my previous videos. So right here, I'm going to make it a little bit smaller, something like that. And then we can also maybe space out the text a little bit and make it even smaller. So kind of get a nice design going here. You can pick a color if you want to. I'm going to center my text. And then all I'm going to do is click these two icons right here, align and transform. And that will actually center my text perfectly within my viewport right here. So I have my text tool that's done. Next, what I want to do is create a new shape layer. So what we'll do is go over here to the pen tool and pick the rectangle tool. And then we're going to create a nice rectangle just like this one. Make it as big as you want. I'm going to make it as wide as my text actually, but of course you can make it exactly how you want it. I'm going to make it rather thin, also like I'm looking at the boldiness of my text, kind of trying to pick the same kind of size in that kind of width of the rectangle, something like that. And then you can also give this a color, like a nice red color, for example, and click OK. Before we continue this video, I would like to present you our website designed for filmmakers and video editors to improve their workflow. We offer templates, presets, high-quality pre-made packs, soundscapes, essential graphics, and much more. If you don't have time to create something of your own, or you just want to speed up your workflow, definitely check out our website with the link in the description below. Now what you want to do is also make sure that this is perfectly centered, and as you can see, your text is a little higher than that rectangle. So what we'll do is go to the text tool and actually position this down a little bit. We really want our text to be perfectly in the center and our rectangle as well. So we can close our text animation right here in the effects controls, go to the shape layer here. So we have the shape, which is our rectangle, and also kind of reposition this perfectly and look at the anchor point and see where the anchor point is located at. So our anchor point is currently here on the left side. And the only way to see is going by the selection tool and clicking on the rectangle. And then right here, you actually see it. And your anchor point is, well, your cursor is actually going to change to this icon. And then you can actually drag around the anchor point to the center, hold control to perfectly select that center point. Maybe even zoom in as much as you can, because right here we want it to be in the center, a little bit more up. And there we go. So now we have our anchor point in the center. Using our selection tool, we can see this little ball that you see right here. Now we can go and fit it back to the work area. Now what I want to do is go to that shape and actually rename it to the top line. And then we're going to copy it and paste it again and rename this to bottom line. Okay, so the bottom line, we're going to uncheck it so we don't see it at all. And now we want to go to that shape on the top line here and animate the position. So right here, we are in the beginning of the timeline in our animation. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so we can see it a little bit more clear. There we go. So the first thing that we want to animate is the scale, but currently we have uniform scale selected. We want to uncheck that and that will reveal the vertical scale and the horizontal scale. We want to change your horizontal scale to 0 and click on stopwatch for the animation. Then move as much as you want. Like, let's say we want to move, we zoom in a little bit, like 1 second. So that's like right here. Let's zoom in on the timeline as well. Here we have 1 second. Actually, we need to extend our layer a little bit more towards, like, let's say 10 seconds. And there we go. So let's play this. And at 1 second, we want to change the scale to 100. So now we have this kind of animation. And then right here, at when it's 100%, we want to click on the stopwatch for the position. That will create a position keyframe at the exact same position where the scale is at 100. And then again, move 1 second. And here we want to click again on this diamond for a position keyframe. So now we have two position keyframes with the exact same values. We'll click on this left arrow key to jump back to the first position keyframe. And here we want to actually position this top line, so we want to position this up. So we're going to animate this right here. And then we want to do, so now we have something like this going on. So it first gets as big as it should be, and then right here at the final end is going to move up. Perfect. So we can actually uncheck our text as well for now. So now we have something like this going on. Pretty cool. Another big step is to smooth out the animation a little bit of that line. So now it's going just in the linear direction. So it just starts and stops at the exact same speed, at the constant speed, actually. We want to actually start from a very high speed and then slowly come to a stop to make it a little bit smoother, a little bit more dynamic and more professional. So how we do that is actually super simple. First, let's focus on the scale right here. We have this last keyframe. We want to select that, right click. We're going to ease it in because it's actually coming in. So we're going to select that, and that will change our keyframe right here to something like this. And then right here we have this arrow which we can open up as well. And we can actually drag in this line that you see right here. If you see, if you hover over that, your mouse or your cursor actually changes. You can click on that and just drag it to the left and just make sure that you're kind of staying on the same height, and now you will have something like this. So it actually speeds up at the beginning and slowly comes to a stop for the scale. And now we want to do exactly the same thing for the position, but we want to work both ways. So we want to start off slowly, ramp up in speed, and slowly come to that stop at the end. So how we do that is actually select this and go to the temporal interpolation, ease out, and then right here on the last one, we want to select temporal interpolation, ease in. And now we want to also open up that arrow for the position and do the same thing. So we have these two anchor points, or actually, I'm not sure how we call these, but actually if you drag this to the right and this one to the left, we're going to get something like this. Of course, you can smooth it out a little bit and make it not as exaggerated. So something like this. And now we have something cool and clean like this. And immediately the animation kind of gets a different vibe. Like, it gets a little bit more playful, in my opinion. And it just makes the entire animation work so much better. So what we want to do is do the exact same kind of animation, but now for that bottom line. And reveal that bottom line go to the beginning and also uncheck that uniform scale effect right here. So if we do that, we will be able to animate the horizontal scale normally. So we'll select it big. Sometimes you get this kind of error. So we can close this and go to that bottom line. So we want to do the same thing here. We are going to click on the stopwatch for the horizontal scale and actually move right here to this dot. So we can actually use this as a reference. We have these dots here, which we can use. And right here, we want to click another keyframe, go to the beginning and change this to zero. Right click on this last one and go for ease in. Open up the arrow right here like we did in the first one and just drag this to the left as much as you can. And there we go. So now we have both lines actually kind of scaling up, but of course it also needs the animation down. We actually are going to reveal our text again so we can use this as a reference because we want to kind of keep the space in between our text. So go to that last keyframe here for the scale of our new shape bottom line and click on the stopwatch for the position. Now move to the last dot right here. I'm actually holding shift to make it snap here. We can actually move this one down. So we have it right here. Maybe a little bit more. And there we go. And now we have this cool animation. So of course, right here, we have to right click temporal interpolation ease out. And for this one, temporal interpolation ease in, and then also open up these arrows, kind of bring them in the same kind of exact way you did for the other keyframes. You can always go back and check our reference here and kind of bring your time cursor right here and actually try to bring them and match them as good as possible. So that way the animation is going to be kind of exact. And there we go. So we have these lines coming up. The only last thing that we should do is make our text reveal after these lines are actually animating up. And the way I found to do this is because actually After Effects is much easier to work on animations, and especially if you're going to start working with these smooth animations with ease in and ease out, I find After Effects so much easier. So I'm kind of going to do it like messy, but we're going to get the exact same result that we want to have, but it's a little bit messier and we don't have these clean keyframes for this exact case. But I like to use the effect here. If you go to effects and search for crop, I'm going to apply this crop effect right after our text. So make sure that the bottom line and the top line, so actually I'm going to release it, so we close these two down and bring this crop effect just below the text, but on top of the shapes. And there we go. And then right here at the beginning of the position keyframes, make sure your cursor kind of snaps over there. We're going to create a keyframe for the right, for the bottom and the top. And we're going to change both to 50%. And there we go, we can't see our text anymore. Now we're going to zoom in a little bit here and move two keyframes forward. We're going to do that by clicking on the arrow right key on our keyboard, 1, 2. We don't see any animation going on, so again, 1, 2. Right here, I'm going to create two keyframes again with the same kind of value, 1, 2. Bring these over. So as long as you don't see anything going on here, and right here we start seeing something. So what we wanna do is actually kind of decreasing until you see this text. Same goes for this one. And now we start like frame by frame revealing the crop. You can also click on the crop and actually just make this a little bit bigger. And then move a few frames forward and kind of reveal it that way. And then go back and check wherever our text is not perfectly revealed. Like for example, here we can make it a little bit smaller and stuff like that. But of course, once your text is revealed, that's perfect. And then right here, we'll have to check where the text actually disappears again. And there we go. So now we have this kind of animation. And that's pretty cool. So now what we want to do is do the animation to kind of disappear again. So what we'll do is go to the 3rd second here, approximately. And we're going to create a keyframe again for these two. And now we want to open up all of these things right here. So we're going to start off with just copying this keyframe, paste it over here, copy this keyframe, move it forward, paste it over here, kind of try to get the timing right. Same here for the horizontal scale, copy paste it and reverse these keyframes here. now we have this one going up and then disappearing right here. So this is the first one. Copy, paste, reverse. Then copy, paste these and reverse. Well, here it's going to be a little bit more difficult for the crop. So we're just going to start off here, create keyframes again, move all the way till the end here and change it back to 50%. And then just go in between and see where it works and it doesn't work. So it kind of seems like it works pretty good. So I'm going to keep it as it is. I do see a little mistake here in our rectangle. And to fix that, it's actually really simple. We're going to ease it out here instead of in. So we're just going to change it back to linear, right click, ease out. And now we have this better animation. Same for the bottom one. So we're going to right click here, linearize it, and then right click and ease it out. So we don't have that kind of in between going on. I know this might be a little hard if you have never worked with kind of keyframing some animations, but it's so simple once you understand how ease in, ease out, and just, yeah, easy ease works in general. All right, so there we go. We have our animation going, which is pretty cool. Right here at the end, I'm actually going to trim my video all the way till the end. So now we have our first and last keyframes right here. Now what I want to do is right here on top, you see these blue kind of boxes, which you can drag in all the way until here. And then the same for these, drag these in all the way till here. So try to cover all the keyframes that are about the animation in. And then try to cover all the animation out keyframes. Double check by scrolling through them. I see that everything is in this kind of gray box. And now we can kind of extend it as much as we want. And you can see that now, if we're going to select these two, the gray kind of keeps the keyframes together and everything in between gets longer. So that's a really cool way to get our in animation right here and our out animation right here. All right, so that's how to create this effect in Adobe Premiere Pro. I know it's a kind of a difficult way on creating something really simple, but that's why I created the essential graphics for this, which is really simple to use. You can simply go in Adobe Premiere Pro, go to your essential graphics here, browse for this effect, the elegant title reveal dragged into your timeline, and simply click here and go to the edit. Change the color easily. The line thickness here. The line width. And the text color. And of course, some text scale. And now you immediately have that kind of animation. Plus, I added something extra in Adobe After Effects to create a more dynamic look to the text animation. Kind of a 3D depth kind of text pop-up effect. So you can go and get that on our website and it helps to support the channel for sure. So links are in the description. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel for more and definitely check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists, and much more. And apart from that, I'll hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.